This video covers two sessions in October, fishing the blocks at Southsea. I was hoping to fish this mark in the summer, but there's always people here when I visited. I fished here on consecutive days, mainly because of what's just happened now. I had a big fish on my first cast, but lost it as I was trying to set up my camera. It had pulled my rod right round. I didn't know what it was, but it's bitten me off. This was on one of my short snood rigs, a beefed up sole rig, but it definitely wasn't a sole. Before I repair that rig, I'm casting out a 3-hook clip down rig with ragworm and lugworm. I've started halfway up the tide and the water isn't pulling much yet. However, before the top of the tide, I am expecting it to be running from left to right. Just before I cast out this rig, I'll run through the locational details. Southsea is on Portsea Island, which is pretty much synonymous with Portsmouth, and is right at the eastern end of the Solent. Portsea Island is between Portsmouth Harbour and Langstone Harbour, and Southsea is right at the southern end, and adjacent to Eastney. I'm zooming in and identifying some of the nearby venues before homing in on the blocks themselves. The blocks are World War II anti-submarine defences and are found to the east of South Parade Pier. You can park along the seafront or at a large pay and display car park at Canoe Lake. The blocks are exposed at low water and identified by a row of marker posts. I'm casting towards the posts to be near to the blocks themselves. One rig would be cast long, while the other one would be slightly shorter. It didn't take long for my next bite. It's not one of those big fish that bit me off, but I'm happy with this catch. It's the species I was expecting here, a black bream, and this one's quite a decent size. And very lively. Even though you do get decent sized bream on lugworm, I prefer to use ragworm. The tide's now started to run, and my rigs are being pulled away from the blocks to my right. Quick pan round the area, then a look at my setup. I've got my usual gear, Comic 07 rods and Pen Affinity reels with braid. However, I've had to purchase a new rucksack since my other one fell apart, and I had been using it with broken zips and tears, which had been letting some water in. I've already mentioned my rigs, which are clipped down catch anything rigs, although I mainly use them for flatfish, although I'm not really expecting flatfish here at this time. I know it can be a pain moving your gear up and down a beach, but I like to be close to the water's edge, so it's not very often that I set up at the strand line. Getting a few little taps on my left hand rod, so before moving them up the beach I'd like to see what it is. As well as the weed, there is a fish on here. So those little taps were from a nicely marked wrasse. I now spot a bite on the other rod. And this is another decent sized bream. Next cast and I get another wrasse. Things quiet down as it's pulling hard over high water. It takes a couple of hours into the ebb until I get my next bite. Unfortunately, my camera stops recording as I'm about to land my third bream. It's also of decent size, and I get another wrasse before I pack up. A fairly good session, but I was a bit annoyed about the lost fish at the start. I was keen to find out what that fish was, so the following day I decided to arrive early as it was still low water. The concrete blocks are exposed, and I've given myself plenty of time to set up and, importantly, get that camera ready. Since there was some bream about the day before, I brought some squid with me, so my first task is to cut a couple into small strips. These will be used to tip the ragworm. Although I'll also be using the rigs from the previous day, I'm beating up one of my specialised bream rigs. Instead of Aberdeens, these I've got Camazan B983 hooks. You may notice I've got quite a large lead with wires on. The day before, I had to switch over to these from Continental leads because it was towing so hard. It's normally easier to bait these chino style hooks with bait needles, but I'm not really keen on using them unless I'm in a hurry. Here, it looks like I'm struggling to put the ragworm on, so I should really have got that bait needle out. I normally pass the hook point through the strip of squid twice. A holographic sequin and a luminescent bead acts as a bait stop. This is the two snood rig I used at the start of the last session, however, this time I've not had a bite on it first cast. For the moment, I'm not casting too close to the blocks since the tide is running from right to left. I'm expecting my rigs to be pulled towards the blocks though. When the tidal pull is on the turn, I'm aiming to try and get closer to the blocks. Time to switch the free hook rig with the Aberdeens over to the bream rig. Spot a loop in my line on the spool, so I need to go back and unwind until I get to that point. If I leave it there, it might affect my next cast. Tide's coming in and covering the blocks, but I've not had a bite yet. Even so, it's still time to move up the beach. As the tidal pool slackens off, I get my first bite. I'm into a fish, and it seems quite decent. It feels similar to the one I lost at the start of the last session. On first inspection, it looks like a very dark dogfish. I soon realise it's not a dogfish, but a house. Maybe that's the fish that bit me off last time. You certainly don't want to put your fingers into its mouth. However, it's not the teeth, but the nasal flaps which distinguish this from a dogfish. Even so, it can be very difficult to tell the difference between the two. Just wanted to check again, however I'm still not certain, but for the sake of argument I'm going to put this down as a wrasse and not a dogfish, and I like to think that a fish that bit me off the day before was its bigger brother. then put in a spider crab, which to me seems rather unseasonal. I suppose some of them hang around all year round, but you normally expect them in late spring and into the summer. Next bite's a couple of little taps which are worth trying to hit. Having moved my rods up the beach and tightened up, I get a little knock. I suppose I got the interest of a passing fish whilst I was dragging the baits whilst moving my rods. It's a nicely coloured wrasse on a top hook. It looks like the rig on my other rod has moved out of position. I then spot the tip move, so I strike into it. I can feel a bit of resistance there. It's a fairly decent fish, and I wasn't expecting that. It's quite a nice codling. Next fish in is a black bream, but not the size of the ones the day before. weather then starts turning nasty. I get another wrasse and another black bream before the weather persuades me to start packing up. Although it was a very quiet start, I'm still pretty pleased with the session, having caught two half-decent fish.